section throughout the world. And the different non-invasive scores have also come, like FibroScan and MR kaloscopy. Then aims and objective of our study was to diagnose non-alcoholic fatty liver disease on ultrasonography and CT scan on patients attending our outdoor and indoor, and completely they were diagnosed as fatty liver. And to study insulin resistance and other metabolic lacquer of lipid profiles, hypertension in these patients. Metal methods was, it's a type of case control study done in our medical college, MPC Medical College. The period of study was from 2009 to 2021, around 2 years. We took 50 cases and around 50 control. The inclusion criteria were all the patients, they were diagnosed as NAFLD by the ultrasonography, by the criteria set by the American Gastroenterology Association. The age group was more than 18 years, and the other exclusion criteria was used. And subjects are considered as cases if they have fatty liver as per the guidelines set by the American Gastroenterology Association. And this study was mostly done to see the association of this non-alcoholic fatty liver disease with insulin resistance that we calculated by the help of OMI index, BMI, serum glucose, lipid profile. So in the 50 cases that we took, we find that 46% of the patients were having grade 1 fatty liver, and 46% among them was having grade 2, and only 4% of the patients were having grade 3 fatty liver. And the mean age group in our study was found to be around 46.50, the minimum being 21 and the maximum being 65. So in our study we found from young to adult, any age group can be affected by this disease known as non-alcoholic fatty liver disease. The mean BMI was 24.89, which is significantly high in our Asian population. And you can see the last graph, that is BMI of more than 30. When the BMI increases, the grade of fatty liver also increases from grade 1 to grade 3. In the last graph, you are seeing there is no grade 1 fatty liver. There is only grade 2 and grade 3 fatty liver when the BMI increases. So this is the mean fasting blood sugar of around 112. And out of the 50, these NAFLD patients, 19 were having diabetes mellitus and 6 were having impaired glucose tolerance status. So most of the patients were having some sort of impairment in the glucose status. So but we calculated this by the help of HOMA-IR index, that is widely used for the calculation of insulin resistance. And out of the patient, 58% were having this insulin resistance by the help of HOMA-IR index. The mean HOMA-IR was found to be 3.28, which is significantly very high. And with insulin resistance, most of the patients are obviously diabetic. The diabetic status, you can see all the patients, they were having insulin resistance, that symbolized by the help of this blue graph. And this is a correlation study by the fasting blood sugar and HOMA-IR index. So it symbolizes a positive correlation graph. Means when the insulin resistance increases, the fasting blood sugar among the patients were found to be high. Insulin, serum insulin fasting was also found to be high when there is more HOMA-IR value. The serum triglyceride and serum cholesterol, it was also found high when the insulin resistance increases. The HDA shows a negative correlation graph. Means as the insulin resistance increases, the more the person they were having decreasing HDA status. LDL is found to be high, and all the graphs show statistically significant. So summarizing my lipid profile status, a patient with NAFLD, we found that most of the patients are having a positive correlation graph with LDL, triglyceride, cholesterol, and a negative correlation graph with HDL. So this is a case control study. So the BMI in the cases you see, that is 24.8, and control it was 22.6. So it is like waist circumference, hip circumference, blood pressure, fasting blood sugar, bilirubin, AST, ALT, everything is high in the cases as compared to the controls. And the triglyceride, LDL, and fasting serum insulin is also high, and HDL is low in the cases. And the HOMA-IR is 3.3 and it is 1.7 as compared to the cases and the controls. So summarizing the study, so our study, it reveals that there is a higher prevalence of insulin resistance in cases of non-alcoholic fatty liver disease, and disease patients who are those that are associated with mostly type 2 diabetes mellitus and obesity. So in this era where the NAFLD has the leading cause of chronic liver disease, every patient that is coming from fatty liver, we should assess for this disease, and recent studies are also going on to find the cause of this insulin resistance, and also new drugs have come. These are my references. Thank you so much, sir.
Good presentation. What is your feeling? Which is the safest BMI for Asian population?
Sir, for Asian,
rather recommended.
They have considered for Asian it is like 23. For like WHO it is 25, sir. But Asian they have mostly found that most of us have their BMI from 18 to 23, sir.
And when you collect those samples, fasting or random?
No, fasting, sir. We have collected fasting wherever random.
So, what is there new in your study? Do you know that NAFLD is a resistant liability, the part of the thing, as any insulin resistance? So, what is new?
Yes, sir. We have found that most of them with diabetic status is very high, sir.
That is what I am telling you. Insulin resistance with diabetic hypertension is high. Okay. Have you included lean NFL?
No, sir.
But your graph shows that more the BMI, the resistance pattern is there. What is your study? Whether you include a lean NFL, because this is a new concept.
Yes, sir.
And most of the diabetic are also those who are taking insulin. They are also lean diabetes are taking insulin. So what is your opinion regarding lean diabetes, lean NFL? Because you have not included those things.
Yes, sir.
And your study, it shows that these are all known. So what new thing you want to give message to the society or Dr. Friedrich so that this study shows?
Yes,
so what is new in this
study? Yeah, in this study we have found that lipid profile status has severely impact.
Is also there?
Yes, sir.
Is also there?
And blood pressure was significantly high.
Is also there?
Yes, sir.
It is there, right? These are all because insulin resistance is part of metabolic syndrome. Okay. So what is new in this study? And your opinion regarding lean NFL?
Sir, we have taken all the patients, not like that I have excluded the lean patients, sir. All the patients were diagnosed and routine ultrasound.
Your graph.
Most, yeah.
Your graph doesn't show that there are some patients who are having BMI is less than 20 like that.
Yes,
so everywhere you have highlighted the normal NFL. But the graph doesn't show about lean NFL.
Sir, mostly in patients, the mostly they don't have NFL, sir. It is mostly found in obesity and BMI pattern.
It is a new term, lean NFLD.
Lean NFLD is
how is it?
Lean
NFLD. It is a new term.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. The patients are also very less, sir.
Very less, but it is there.
Yes, sir. LDL was significant, it was high as compared to all the lipid profile status. LDL was mostly high, sir. HDL is also decreased, but LDL from among all these, LDL is mostly high. Less than 15 female and less than 14 male will be considered as unsafe. It should be more than 14 male and more than 15 female as per Asian guidelines. We are seeing, sir.
14 and 15.
Yes, sir.
Thank you, sir. I'd like